Hello friends, and in this video I'll be helping you with circuit switching as well as packet switching, and also will be the comparison between circuit switching as well as packet switching. So let's start with it. First of all, let's discuss about circuit switching. So network dedicated channel has to be established before the call is made between users. What it actually means is, let's come on the diagram. So here's the diagram. If user A wants to communicate with user C, then it needs to maintain a connection before, or you can say it needs to have a network dedicated channel before any kind of communication. The channel is reserved between the users till the connection is active. So till the connection is active, the channel will be reserved and no other user can use that channel. So if user B requests also, it will get a busy signal till the connection is active. So for half duplex communication, one channel is allocated, and for full duplex communication, two channel is allocated. So you can see the diagram, only one channel is allocated. So this is a kind of half duplex communication, but for full duplex, two channels are allocated. It is mainly used for voice communication requiring real-time services without any much delay. For example, you call your friend, and what you actually do is you press the dialing button, you press the number of your friend, you dial the number of your friend and you press call button, then the ring goes and that person picks, then a connection is maintained, then you start communicating. And even if you are talking, if you are not talking, it doesn't matter, the call will stay connected, and once you press the cut button, then only it will be disconnected. So connection will be maintained. It doesn't matter if the user is sharing data or user is communicating or not. And the connection needs to be inactive, then only user B or any other user can call. So it's like when you call someone or you call your friend, your number is busy and your friend's number whom you're calling is also busy till the time you both talk. And when you end up calling or when you end the call, then only another person can call. So that is a kind of example of circuit switching. Now let us come on packet switching. So in packet switching, unlike circuit switching, it is not required to establish a connection initially. You don't need to have an initial connection. Secondly, channel connection is available to use by many users, but when capacity or number of users increase, then it will lead to congestion in a network. I will come to that. Don't worry, just wait for a minute. Are mainly used for data and voice application requiring non-real-time scenarios. Now let us come on what actually it means. Like if user A wants to communicate with user C, it does not needs to have a P, or you can say network dedicated channel. It can simply communicate, and if user B also wants to communicate at same time, it also can communicate, and the communication will go normally, but the performance will degrade as the rate of data transmission increases. And if congestion is made, then you can say the data can be hanged also, the communication can be hanged also. But if the data transmission is low, then all the users, as multiple users, can communicate with same channel, or you can say have a common path. So this is a good thing in packet switching network. It is preferred for places where there is no real-time scenarios, for example voice application as well as data applications. Now let us compare between circuit switching as well as packet switching networks. So in packet switching network, quality of services is not guaranteed by so, because you can see that in packet switching, if user A and user C are communicating at that same time, user B and user D also communicated, and a congestion happens over here, then quality of service will become dim. So that is not guaranteed, but that's not the case in circuit switching, because the network is dedicated before only, or you can say initially only. So that's not the case in circuit switching. So this is a good thing, a positive point in circuit switching. Secondly, PSS is used for time incentive application, where time is not a worry. Like you want to mail someone, then time doesn't matter. Like if it reaches even after 5 seconds, 10 seconds, it doesn't matter. It's not that like it is reaching after 10 years or 5 years, but like you can afford to afford a time of 5 to 10 seconds or a delay of few seconds, then you can use packet switching. Like sending an email using internet, SMS, MMS, or VoIP, etc. So for that, packet switching is used. In case of circuit switching, even if user is not talking, the channel cannot be used by any other user, and this is a waste of resource capacity at the interval. So this is the kind of disadvantage the circuit switching has, but it provides a very good advantage, that is quality of service. That is very, very important when communication is done. So this was all about circuit switching and packet switching. In my next video, I'll be talking about message switching also. So thanks for watching, and if you like the video, do hit the like button and do consider subscribing, and thanks for watching.